three little Virginia girls, Haley, Jennifer, and Lucy. Three different stories of families in the fight of their life. This is Haley. Don't look away. Her parents want you to see this. They want you to know what her life is like on a daily basis. She had more than 800 major seizures last year alone.
To see it's real, I get the compliments, or I get when we go out in public, they'll think, well, you keep her nice, or, you know, she seems so happy. And it's like, well, you don't see her in this state.
The Smith family lives in the Northern Neck. Haley started having seizures at 5 months old. She has Dravet syndrome, a severe form of epilepsy with no clear treatment. Haley functions at the level of a 3 to 5 year old. She's been through 21 different medications.
But these are life-threatening seizures, and one day one of them will take her life.
14-year-old Jennifer Collins has a different form of epilepsy, and she's been through 13 different drugs, some of them not even FDA approved.
We have no other options in terms of existing medications. One of them that she's on now is clearly experimental.
The side effects of her pharmaceutical drugs:
depression, suicidal thoughts, weight gain, cognitive issues, anger, hair loss.
Can be just as bad as her 300 seizures each day. She was falling behind in school.
She's going to go one of two ways. If we stick with where we are now, she'll never be the person that she could be.
The Collins made the painful decision to split up the family. Patrick and his other daughter stayed behind in Fairfax. Beth and Jennifer moved 1,700 miles away to Colorado, where medical marijuana is legal.
It's tough, you know. It's tough. She wants to come home. She misses her dad.
Right now, 20 states and the District of Columbia have legalized medical marijuana.
We're not advocating for legalization. We're not giving our kids something that's making them high. It's not something that you smoke.
It's an oil, a benign oil from a plant that happens to have a bad reputation.
But it's something that has proven to work for kids with epilepsy.
Families in Colorado are seeing immediate results.
She is starting to score better on her math tests and other tests. She is telling us, I feel 90% better.
Lisa Smith can't move to Colorado. She's hoping Virginia changes its law. Right now, Virginia only allows for the possession of marijuana for medical purposes. But doctors can't write prescriptions. Delegate Bob Marshall from Northern Virginia has even tried to repeal what's in place. He told the Washington Post just last month, to do these experiments on kids in the absence of science, I question that. But Virginia families like the Rodens from Stanton say they don't have time to wait for the FDA or science to catch up.
I have a very small window of time in which to protect my daughter's intellect. Right now, she's developing normally. Right now.
From home video, you can see Lucy is a happy 2.5-year-old.
You like Jeopardy?
I like Jeopardy.
This is Lucy, 10 minutes later, lying on a bed. Dazed, seizing, getting oxygen. This is her daily life.
It's okay, sweetie. It's okay, baby.
As any parent who watches their child suffer might understand, their hope is huge.
I really can't afford to wait. None of us can afford to wait. We are three families. We represent more. We're Virginia's children.